say this sooner. I just believe that I was all displaced.
Hey, I'm Jen Lowe from Boom Boom Television, and joining me today is Aaron Gillespie. Say hey.
Hey, how are you?
Aaron. Good, how are you?
I'm great.
Thanks for doing this interview with
us. You're welcome.
Aaron is currently on tour with Underoath, and he also fronts his own band called The Almost. He's amazing, and he's a vinyl artist.
I am.
And can you tell us a little bit about what cymbals you use for a vinyl?
I use like a 21, a 24. 22, sometimes a 22 here, and another 22 here. 15-inch hats, dry, like jazz hats, hand hammer ones. But I'm always kind of, you know, yeah. Cymbals, you know?
Yeah.
I go through like one every 3 days, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Constantly changing and...
Heavy hitter. Have you gotten into any of the MB20 series?
I do. I actually have a custom cymbal. It's a 22-inch crash MB20 cymbal.
Okay.
Well, MB20 and Bythus are same alloy.
Right.
Just finished different.
Right, exactly.
So, I love the MB20 cymbals. They're just a little bit, I sing all the time.
Yeah.
Behind a kit, mm-hmm. So it's a little bit of an issue.
Right.
You know.
Coming through the mic.
They're so shimmery.
Yeah. Okay.
So it's a little bit of an issue right now. Even with Bison cymbals, I have to put a square of tape underneath them.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's interesting. So speaking of singing a little bit, you also have your band called The Almost.
I do.
And your CD just came out.
April 3rd.
Nice. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I went on and I checked it out and I went out to the MySpace side of things.
Cool.
Saw some video of you guys.
Cool.
Rocking it out. And I really enjoy that aspect. There's a couple other drummers that I know of that also play guitar and sing and have their own bands as well as doing national tours with,
sure.
You know, bands behind kids. Tell me a little bit about, let's talk about The Almost for a second. How long have you guys been playing together? Because I know that you wrote everything and
you also
played all the other
stuff. There's actually four other guys. Band and one of them came along last July and then they slowly trickled on after that, but kind of a boring story, but everyone just is they're really great musicians and really respect them and it's going really well.
Did you do the recruiting yourself to get them into The Almost or?
Yes and no. My wife found the drummer, oddly enough, and then my old drum tech found a lead guitar player and then he kind of
okay.
And the other guitar player, the rhythm guitar player, he's a buddy of mine from years and years ago. He's actually the first guy I called and he was unavailable at the time.
So how is it having somebody else play your drum parts that you laid down on a track?
It's a little weird because I'm in control a lot. You know, as a drummer, you drive the truck, you know. And with Underoath, you know, I drive the truck. It doesn't start unless I want it to.
Right.
You
right.
know what I mean? Like,
yeah, absolutely.
So it's kind of weird not being in control at the same time. He's an 18-year-old kid, he's a prodigy, he's going to be somebody great someday. Uh-huh. So
you have any issues when you guys are rehearsing, you know, that you hear something in your head and you're trying to translate it to him and he can't really understand what you're saying?
Not so bad. I mean, there's little issues like that in every band, but it's not like where I'm like, hey dude, you're a jerk, you're not playing this right. You know, he's great, he plays with a click, gets it done.
What's his name, the drummer?
Kenny Bozick.
Does he use the mono flip as well?
He does.
Nice.
He does.
Nice. Okay, great. We'll have to tackle him next.
Yeah.
Also, on some of the videos that I watched on MySpace, I see that there are songs that you're playing guitar on, and then there's other songs where you're just singing, and I don't mean just, but that you're singing without a guitar. Do you find it awkward to not have an instrument on when you step out in front without your drums or without a guitar?
No, I actually don't. At first, I felt a little bit naked, but no, I mean, I sing behind the kit all the time, so I think that it's kind of a natural progression in some way.
Right. I think as drummers, when you sit behind the drum set, we kind of watch, you know, what goes on.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel like you get inspired or you maybe have certain people that you have played with, or maybe it's the guys in Underoath that you know, find that inspiration to perform when you step out in front of the kit?
Oh, sure. I mean, last year, the end of the year last year, we were on tour with Take Back Sunday. Underoath was overseas, Japan, Australia, all over Europe and England. And their guitar player had a family emergency, had to go home, and the guitar player sings half the stuff. And I had to fill in and sing. And it really kind of cut my teeth, but it made me see that I really do want to be out front with it.
Right.
And it was great.
Everybody always asks me this, do you have a preference between playing kit or fronting a band?
If I couldn't do either, I'd be miserable.
Right.
The fact that I get to do both.
Yeah.
It's good.
It's wonderful, right?
I'm having a good time.
Yeah, it's fun. It's the, you know, when I tell people that, you know, that, hey, I write songs, sometimes they pat me on the back and they say, that's nice. You know, do you ever have that controversy where, like, you say, yeah,
no,
I just want to
over it? I did at first, but I think people are taking it a little more serious now, maybe. But I don't want to be the type of musician where I don't want to be called a musician. I want to be called a songwriter. You know,
yeah.
I don't want. I mean, down the road, I don't. You know, I don't want someone to say I was great in my craft. Of course, I want to say that. I don't want them to know though that all I could do was play 32nd notes with my feet and a clave with my left hand at the same time. I mean, that's great. But
yeah.
I want to write songs.
Yeah.
You know.
I understand.
People don't remember the Beatles for a guitar solo or because Ringo was playing a biome with his right foot and a freaking, you know, clave with his right hand and playing a 4/4 beat with his left hand. They don't remember because of that. They remember because of that guy. They wrote incredible songs.
Absolutely.
You know?
Yeah.
And that's my goal as a musician. I'm not interested in becoming. And sure, I liked all the techie stuff too. I like to listen to it. And
yeah.
Those guys are freaks of nature and that's great, but I'm interested in writing a song and can roll your window down. And
now you finish up this sort of mini tour that you were telling me about as far as Underoath is concerned?
In a week, yeah. And then I've got a bunch of radio shows at The Almost, and then I've got a month off. I'm going to go to Hawaii and, I have a bunch of radio shows, and I got a week off, and then Underoath goes to Australia, and we play in Hawaii, then I'm going to stay. Then I have a month off, I'm going to stay in Hawaii, and then I'm going to go to Mexico for a little bit and sit on the beach.
Now, it said on MySpace that you guys were going to be part of the Warped Tour.
And then right after that's the Warped Tour.
And when does that start?
29th of June.
Okay. Excellent. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are you looking forward to playing for
all? Yeah, it's my fourth year in a row. So I've pretty much lived on that tour for the last 4 years.
Right.
So.
Right. Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for doing this.
Absolutely.
You guys definitely go check out The Almost and check out Underoath. Aaron's an amazing musician all the way around. And he rocks. So this is Jen Lowe from BoomBoom Television. Rock on.
Seems like every time we're here